This video is to allow you to correct your homework from section 6.1.4, problem 651 through 660. First of all, you have to name the coordinates of each point as ordered pairs. So if you notice, this is actually going by threes on the horizontal and on the vertical. So that means A would be 6 across and 3 up. So A would have the value of 6, 3. B would be 3 across, 12 up, so 3, 12. C, it's kind of hard to tell what this is at, but based on the fact that this is 9 and this is 12, this is probably meant to be 10, and this is probably meant to be 8. So I would say that C would be 10, 8. And then D, based on that same reasoning, 15 is clear. But I would say this is about 2, maybe 2.5, and if you went with that, that's fine too. At the school's fall bake sale, all the pies were cut into 6 pieces, so each person who bought a piece bought 1/6 of a pie. Each slice of pie sold for $1. How much money did the school make if all 11 pies were sold? In other words, what's 11 divided by 1/6? Now, you do need to show your work for this. You can either show 11 circles representing the pies, show that you divided them into 6, and how many pieces you would have. You could also do it by 11 divided by 1/6, where you do your keep, change, flip. So you keep 11 over 1, change your division sign to a multiplication sign, and flip, in other words, the reciprocal of the second fraction. And then now you're set up for multiplication. You multiply as usual. So you get 66 over 1 or 66. So you can either show it with a diagram or you can show it with your division using your keep, change, flip technique. And then, of course, if they sell 66 pieces and each piece sells for $1, they're going to make $66. Find the area and perimeter of a rectangle that has these dimensions. So, again, you can see that I just have the answer, but you need to have some work shown. So the area would be showing that you multiplied these two values, because we know that's how we found the area of a rectangle, length times width, and you get 84 and 1/10 square meters. And for perimeter, you should show that you added, 14 and 5/10 and 5 and 8/10 plus 14 and 5/10 again plus 5 and 8/10 again. In other words, 2 of the lengths plus 2 of the widths, equaling the total of 40 and 6/10 meters. Here you have to write these as products of its prime factors. Again, make sure you're showing some work. So remember, for prime factorization, you can do it with, oh my, that's a bad looking 3. You can do it with either technique that I've shown you before, which is, start by dividing by the lowest prime, which is 2, giving you 15. Oh my goodness, that's bad looking writing. 15 will not divide by 2, but it will divide by the next lowest prime, which is 3, giving you 5. Okay, in which case your answer would be 2 times 3 times 5. Then the other way you could do it, but again, you have to have some work some way shown, is you could do it with your factor tree. So you could go, all right, 30 is 5 times 6. 5 is a prime number, so I'm going to circle that. 6 can be further broken down into 2 times 3. I'm going to circle those because they're prime, and then make sure at the end that the answer is in order. So it's got to be 2 times 3 times 5, not 5 times 2 times 3. For the other ones, again, make sure you're showing your work, but like for 300, there ends up being 2 times 2 times 3 times 5 times 2, pardon me, 2 times 2 times 3 times 5 times 5, which is the same as 2 to the second power times 3 times 5 to the second power. 17 is a prime number. It cannot be broken down any further, so it just stays 17. And 21 is just 3 times 7. So again, with this 300 one, which might have been one of the more difficult ones, you should have gotten when you did your prime factorization. I'll try to get bigger print here. You should have gotten 2 times 2 times 3 times 5 times 5, and again, since they told you to use exponents, to represent repeated multiplication. That would be 2 to the second power, because 2 twos are being multiplied, times 3 times 5 to the second power. Here you have to copy the pattern. Draw the fifth and sixth figures on your paper. So what we want you to notice is that in terms of the pattern, figure 5 will have 5 vertical dots and 9 horizontal dots. Well, how do we know that? Well, what we see is that we have, for example, in figure 2, 2 vertical, 2 horizontal. In figure 3, 3 vertical, 4 horizontal. In figure 4, 4 vertical, 6 horizontal. All right. In figure 1, 1 vertical, none horizontal. So you could look at that as, you know, the figure number is the number of dots vertical, and then the number of dots horizontal is 0, then 2, then 4, then 6. Okay. Otherwise, there's other ways to view it that maybe would be a pattern that makes more sense for you. You could look at it as though we're looking at, and this comes up when they ask you to describe it, you could look at it as like figure 2 has basically the number again of vertical dots, and then for the horizontal dots, it's always going to be 2 times that value minus 1. So for example, for 3 here, we have 3 times 2, which would be 6, but minus 1 gives you 5. 4 would be 4 times 2, which would be 8, but minus 1 gives you 7. 2 would be 2 times 2 is 4, minus 1 gives you 3. So again, that's a little bit possibly confusing. You kind of have to look for what the pattern is that makes the most sense to you. But figure 5 then would have 5 vertical dots and 9 horizontal. Again, 5 times 2 minus 1. Figure 6 would have 6 vertical dots and 11 horizontal, 6 times 2 minus 1. We just said figure 20 would have 20 vertical dots and 39 horizontal, 20 times 2 minus 1. And then figure 20 we just talked about here would have a total of 58 dots. Now you might say 20 plus 39, that doesn't equal 58. Well, remember, if you look at the pattern the way we're describing it here, this dot is getting counted twice. It's getting counted in the vertical and in the horizontal. So in terms of how many dots we have, we'd have 20 plus 38 because we don't want to count that dot twice. That's how they got the 58. Here you have to graph them. And when you do that, it looks like this. Then they want you to figure out the area of the shape. Okay, so you can break this into smaller rectangles and you can go horizontally, you can go vertically. But what you should find is the area is 14 square units. Now, if you did this on graph paper, you could just count the number of squares inside here. But make sure, again, you show your work. And then the perimeter, again, if this is on graph paper, you can just count the number of units around the shape and getting you back to where you started, which is 20. Here, Ms. Perez is giving her class a pizza party because every student completed the school-wide book reading challenge. If an extra large pizza costs $15 and serves 8 people, how much should she expect to pay for the pizzas if her class has 28 students? Well, basically, she's going to have to pay $60, and the reason why is 28 students, if we divide that by 8, we're going to get 4 pizzas, but then we're also going to have 4 people left who haven't had pizza. So in other words, that's going to be, you know, that's not going to work for us. So I hope that I said that correctly. If I didn't say that correctly, I apologize. Maybe let me restate that another way. 8 people per pizza times 3 pizzas means we'll feed 24 people, but we still have another 4 students because 28 minus 4 means there's 4 people that haven't eaten, okay? So we're going to need to buy the extra pizza. We're going to need to buy 4 pizzas. So 3 is not enough. 4 is what we're going to need. And 4 times $15 gives you $60. Okay. Another way you could have done it is you could have taken 28 divided by 8, and you would see that you would get the decimal 3 and 5 tenths, or 3 and a half is a mixed number. But again, we know that we can't buy a partial pizza. Round up to 4 and then multiply by $15 per pizza. Here, you need to make sure that you fill in the missing parts. So, for example, we'd say 20 times what equals 1,600, and that, of course, would be 80. And then, 20 times 6, this would be 120. 80 times what gives you 560? Well, that would be 7. 7 times 6 gives you 42. And then you should show that you added all those sections up and got the total. And then the same concept here. So what do we multiply by 5 to give you 45? Well, this would be 9. 9 times what gives you 3,600 or 3,600? And that would be 400. 400 times 30 would be 12,000. 30 times 5 is 150. And 30 times what equals 2,700? Well, that'd be times 90. 90 times 9 would be 810. Bit messy here, sorry. So, again, show that you've added up all the sections and what you get. In each problem, you have to assume that people divided the food evenly. Write our answer as a division problem in fraction form. So, if two people share one soda, how much are they each getting? One soda divided by two means they're each getting half. If two people share three hamburgers, how much are they getting? Three hamburgers divided by two would be three halves or 1.5 hamburgers. Three people share a large box of fries, then you're each getting 1/3 of the box of fries. Three people share seven brownies. Seven divided by three is 7/3, which becomes the mixed number, 2 1/3. Two people share five apple turnovers, five divided by two, 5/2 or 2.5. And five people share three cartons of chow mein, 3 divided by 5, 3/5. So you're always taking the amount of the food divided by the number of people. And if it's an improper fraction, change it to a mixed number. Here, they're giving you the percentage of 145%, and they want you to complete the portions web. So what's the decimal for 145%? It is 1 45/100. Move the decimal two places to the left, drop the percent sign. The fraction for that would be 1 45/100 as a mixed number, which simplifies to 1 9/20. Again, where we're getting that is 45/100, both top and bottom will divide by 5. And when you do that, you get 9/20. Don't forget, if you can simplify a fraction, you need to do so. And then your words would be 1 45/100.